Students, welcome to class 8 max. Today we are going to see exercise 3.7. What problem? Number is 7 times another. If the differences is 18, find the numbers. So let the numbers be x and y. One number is 7 times another. Therefore, if you take x, the first number is 7 times the other number. Therefore, x is equal to 7y. If the difference is 18, differences means you have to minus. So, x minus y is equal to 18. Substitute the value of x in the equation. Therefore, x value is 7y minus y is equal to 18. 7 minus 1 is 6. 6y is equal to 18. Y equal to 18 by 6 equal to 3. Now you have to find out the x value. X is equal to 7y means x is equal to 7 into y value is 3, that is 21. Therefore, your answer is x equal to 21, y equal to 3. Next question. The sum of 3 consecutive odd numbers is 75. You know what is mean by consecutive numbers. Consecutive number means the continuous number. So, here they ask, write the sum of 3 consecutive odd numbers. Therefore, let the 3 consecutive odd numbers be x plus 2 x plus 4. You have to get the odd number. Suppose the first x value of x is, suppose you are assuming as 1, means the next number is 1 plus 2 is 3. The next odd number is 1 plus 4 is 5. Sum means you have to add. Therefore, x plus 2 plus x plus 4 equal to 75. So add all the x. 1 plus 1 is 2 2 plus 1 is 3. 3x plus 2 plus 4 is 6 is equal to 75. Now keep the x value as it is and bring the 6 to your right hand side. 75 minus 6 is equal to 69. Therefore, x is equal to 69 by 3, 21. If x value is 21, means x plus 2 is equal to 21 plus 2 is 23. And x plus 4 is equal to 21 plus 4 is equal to 25. Therefore, your answer is 21, 23 and 25. Fifth one, the length of a rectangle is 1 by 3 of its breadth. Therefore, L is equal to 1 by 3 of B. B is equal to, we assume B itself. If its perimeter is 64, perimeter is 64 meter, then find the length and breadth of the rectangle. So, perimeter value they given, you have to use the perimeter of rectangle formula. Perimeter of rectangle, 2 into L plus B units. Perimeter value is 64. L value we are assuming as 1 by 3 into B plus B. That is, breadth we are taking as B itself. Now, if you see here, the denominators are different. And in between plus sign is there. If it is a different denominator, you have to take the common denominator. So the common denominator for 3 and 1 is 3. In 3 table, 3 is divisible by 1. That is 1 into 1 is 1. Into b is b. Plus in 1 table, 3 is divisible by 3 times. Therefore, 3 into b, which is equal to 2. If no number is there, you have to assume as 1. Therefore, 1 plus 3 is 4b by 3. If you bring this 2 to your left hand side, if it is in the multiplication, if you take to another side, divide. Three times, two times. (32) = 4/3 × b. We need only the b value. So bring this 4/3 to your left hand side. If you take this 4/3 to your left hand side, fraction means you have to take the reciprocal. 3/4 = b. In 4 table, 8 times. Therefore, b value is equal to 8 threes are 24, and l value is equal to what they given, 1/3 × b. Therefore, 1/3 × 24, which is equal to 8. Therefore, your answer is l is equal to 8 meter and b is equal to 24 meter. Question: a total of 90 currency notes consisting only of rupees 5 and rupees 10 denomination amount to rupees 500. Find the number of notes in each denomination. So the total number of 90 currency notes consist only 5 rupees and the 10 rupees denomination amount to rupees 500. So we have to find the number of notes in each denomination. Let x and y be the number of currency notes of rupees 5 and rupees 10. Therefore, we can frame the equation, that is x plus y is equal to 90. The total of 90 currency notes. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 90. Consisting only rupees 5 and rupees 10 denomination. Therefore, 5x plus 10y is equal to 500. First equation, this is your second equation. If you see the second equation, 5x plus 10y is equal to 500 is divisible by 5. Therefore, divided by 5, you will get x plus 2y is equal to 100. So, take this one as your second equation. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 90 means x is equal to 90 minus y. Substitute the x value in equation 2. Equation 2 is x plus 2y is equal to 100. Therefore, in the place of x, you have to substitute 90 minus y plus 2y is equal to 100. If you see here, plus 2 and minus 1. Therefore, 2 minus 1 is 1. And greater number sign is plus. Plus y is equal to 100. Therefore, y is equal to 100 minus 90 is equal to 10. then therefore x is equal to 90 minus y, which is equal to 90. Y value is minus 10 is equal to 80. Therefore, number of 5 rupees notes is equal to 80, and number of 10 rupees notes is equal to 10. Seventh question. At present, Tenmoli's age is 5 years more than that of Murali's age. Therefore, write down the present age. Present age, Tenmoli represent as T and Murali is represented as M. Tenmoli's age is 5 years more than the of Murali's age. Therefore, if you take Tenmoli's age is X, more than 5 years more than the Murali. Therefore, X plus 5. Murali's age is X. 5 years ago, the ratio of Tenmoli age to Murali age was 3:2. 5 years ago. That means present age is X plus 5. 5 years ago means you have to minus 5. Therefore, X plus 5 minus 5 and then X minus 5. So, if we see here, X plus 5 minus 5, which is equal to X. And the ratio value they given is, Tenmoli is X, Murali is X minus 5, ratio is given as 3/2. Now, cross multiple. 2x is equal to 3 × x − 5. 2x is equal to 3 × x is 3x. 3 × 5 is 15. + × − is minus. Therefore, bring the like terms together. 2x minus 3x is equal to minus 15. So, 2 minus 3 plus 2 is minus. 3 minus 2 is 1. Greater number sign is minus. Minus 1x is equal to minus 15. If you cancel x and x, value is 15. That is, Tenmoli's age is 15. Murali's age is x minus 5. Therefore, 15 minus 5 is equal to 10. 10 years. Your Tenmoli age. Thank you, students. Remaining 8th, 9th, and 10th sum do as the homework.